Hi. In Excel, built-in functions like sum or average are great, but sometimes we need something more specific. That's where custom functions come in. These custom functions work just like built-in functions, allowing us to perform calculations tailored to our needs. In this tutorial, we'll create two functions using VBA. Let's open the VBA editor by going to the Developer tab or by pressing Alt F11. If the Developer tab is not available in the ribbon, right-click on the ribbon, choose Customize the ribbon, check the Developer option, and click OK. In the Developer tab, click Visual Basic as shown on the screen. This opens the VBA editor. Now, insert a new code module by going to the Insert menu and selecting Module. A new module named Module 1 appears in the Project Explorer. Let's write our first custom function, named Rectangle Area, in the Module 1 code editor. A function must begin with the function keyword, followed by the function name and any required arguments or inputs. The function keyword tells Excel that you're defining a reusable piece of code that performs a calculation and returns a result. This function takes two inputs, length and width, both declared as double. In VBA, double is a data type that stores decimal numbers, allowing for more precise calculations. By specifying as double at the end of the function, we ensure that our function can return a decimal value instead of just an integer. If we use the integer data type, any decimal result would be rounded to the nearest whole number, potentially leading to incorrect calculations. You may have noticed that we assign the calculation result to the function name itself. In VBA, when we assign a value to the function name inside the function, it means this value will be returned as the result of the function. This allows us to use the function inside a worksheet, just like any built-in function. Now that we've written the function, let's see it in action inside an Excel worksheet. Switch back to Excel and enter the formula as shown on the screen. This calculates the area of a rectangle with a length of 50 and a width of 25, returning 1250. Let's try another example. Here, the length is 100 and the width is 26, so the function returns 2600. Now, let's see how it handles decimal values. Since the length is 9.7 and the width is 2.5, the function accurately returns 24.25, demonstrating its ability to handle precise decimal calculations. As you can see, our custom function works just like any built-in Excel function, allowing us to enter inputs and instantly get results. Now let's go back to VBA Editor to create another function named GetInitials. This function extracts the initials from a full name. It takes a name as input, which is type of string, splits it into words, and picks the first letter of each word. These letters are then converted to uppercase and combined to form the initials. For example, John Doe will return JD. Here's how it works. The name is split into words based on spaces. A loop goes through each word and extracts its first letter. Each extracted letter is converted to uppercase and added to the result. The final output is a string of initials. Now, return to Excel and see the function in action on the screen. For the name BrainBell, the formula returns BB since both initials are B. For John Cena, it returns JC, as J is the first letter of John and C is the first letter of Cena. Similarly, for Bruno Mars, it returns BM, automatically converting the lowercase initials to uppercase. You're not limited to entering values directly into the function. You can also use cell references if the data already exists in your Excel sheet. Simply enter the cell address in the formula and press Enter. Excel will automatically read the value from the reference cell and return the result in the formula cell, as shown on the screen. As you can see, creating a custom function in VBA is not difficult. With a little effort, you can build functions that simplify your work. However, keep in mind that VBA functions are only available in the current workbook. If you want your functions to be available in all workbooks, you need to save the file as an Excel add-in. If you found this tutorial helpful, please like, share, and subscribe to my channel for more Excel tips and tutorials. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.